वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक केमिकल काइनेटिक्स। व्हेन वी वांट टू ब्रिंग एनी केमिकल रिएक्शन, स्पेशली वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन थ्री डिफरेंट कंडीशन। दैट इज फर्स्ट कंडीशन, दैट इज वेदर द रिएक्शन इज ऑकर आर नॉट। देन सेकंड, व्हेन यू ब्रिंग द केमिकल रिएक्शन, देन व्हाट इज द एक्सटेंट ऑफ any reaction, extent of chemical reaction, and third is how fast will it occur, how fast reaction will occur. So these are the three different things which may be know before to bring the any chemical reaction. First is the will the reaction occur or not, what is the extent of that particular chemical reaction, and how fast reaction will occur. Now these two things is already explained by the branch that is called as a thermodynamics. Thermodynamics is nothing but the branch of chemistry which deals with the various transformation of the transformation taking place during the chemical or physical processes, that is called as a thermodynamics. Now the answer of this first condition, that is whether the reaction is occur or not, is given by the thermodynamics by considering the energy parameter, that is called as a Gibbs free energy parameter, G. So suppose delta G is negative, then the reaction is occur or reaction is feasible reaction. And suppose the value of delta G is positive, that reaction is non-feasible, means that it does not occur. So this is already explained by the in thermodynamics, that is delta G is negative, reaction is occur. And suppose it is positive, it is non-feasible reaction. Now take the example, suppose any neutralization reaction, suppose hydrochloric acid react with the base NaOH, sodium hydroxide, and it is converted into, means spontaneously converted into NaCl and H2O. Now the delta G value, that is the change in Gibbs free energy value, is negative, means this reaction is occur. And take the reverse of this reaction, suppose then sodium chloride suppose added in water, then this does not this does not give the product, means this reaction does not takes place because delta G is positive value, means this type of reaction, that is the formation of HCl and NaOH, does not occur, and this is because the value of delta G for this particular reaction is negative. So in this way, whether reaction is feasible or not is explained by the concept thermodynamics. Then we come to the second point, that is what is the extent of reaction. The extent of reaction is explained in thermodynamics by considering the parameter called as a equilibrium constant, and this equilibrium constant is related with delta G standard minus 2.303 RT log equilibrium constant. So this equilibrium constant is directly related with the standard Gibbs free energy, and from which we can calculate the what is the extent of reaction. Now the third parameter, that is the how fast reaction will occur, it does not explain by the explain the thermodynamics, means how the fast is reaction, whether reaction is slow or fast, it does not explain. And this topic, that this thing is explained by the new branch called as a chemical kinetics. Now we will discuss the chemical kinetics. Now the chemical kinetics is nothing but the branch of chemistry which deals with rates of chemical reactions and different factors affecting rate of reaction. So this chemical kinetics is nothing but the branch of chemistry which deals with the rate of chemical reaction and factors affecting the rate of reaction. Factor means there are different factors such as temperature, what is the effect of temperature, how it affect the rate of reaction by temperature, then pressure, then concentration of reactant, then surface area, then radiation, the nature of a reactant or product. So these are the various factors affecting the rate of reaction, and all these are studied in chemical kinetics. Then next we discuss about the what is the rate of chemical reaction. Rate of chemical reaction. What is the rate of chemical reaction? Now consider any particular reaction. The rate of reaction is the measure of speed of reactants get converted into product. Means suppose consider R is the reactant. This is the general representation of the chemical reaction. Reactant is converted into product, and the rate of chemical reaction is nothing but the measure of the speed with which the reactants get converted into product. And in another way, how this reactant is converted into product means it is the rate of chemical reaction is the measure of the speed with which reactant get converted into product. Or in other way, the rate of reaction is defined as the change in concentration of this reactant or product per unit time. This is called as a rate of any chemical reaction, that is the change in concentration of reactant on our product per unit time. Now in mathematically, the rate of reaction is written as the rate of chemical reaction is nothing but the, consider this chemical reaction R is converted into product, the rate of reaction. Now in this case, when any chemical reaction is processed, the concentration of this reactant goes on decreasing and concentration of product goes on increasing with respect to time. And therefore, rate of reaction here minus D of concentration of reactant with respect to dt means the concentration of reactant goes on decreasing with respect to time. Or similar way, the concentration of product increases with respect to time. When concentration of reactant decreases, means concentration of product also goes on increasing. So this is the mathematical representation of the rate of reaction, means when 1 mole of reactant is converted into 1 mole of product. The negative sign shows here the concentration of the reactant goes on decreasing with time. So this is about the rate of chemical reaction. Now next is we will discuss about the various factors affecting rate of chemical reaction. So which are the factors? Already I discussed earlier the factors which affect the rate of any chemical reaction. So there are different factors. One is the concentration of reacting molecules or reactants. Then second is temperature. Third, which is mentioned in syllabus, that is the nature of reactant and product. Then next is what is the effect of catalyst on the chemical reaction and rate of reaction. Then what is the effect of surface area? Then what is the effect of radiation? And lastly, what is the effect of pressure? So these are the various factors which may be affect the rate of any chemical reaction. So we will discuss one by one these different factors which how it will affect the rate of chemical reaction. So first we discuss the term, that is the various factors affecting rate of reaction. So first we discuss that is the first concentration of reactant, how the concentration of reactants affects rate of reaction. Concentration of reactants. Now suppose consider when concentration of reacting molecule is high, the probability of their collision and interaction is high, and so the rate of reaction is very high. Means as the this clearly shows that the concentration is of reactants is directly proportional to the rate of reaction. It is directly proportional, means when the concentration of the reacting molecule is increases, the rate of reaction is also increases, because there is a, when concentration of reactants is very high, there is a high possibility or probability to interact the reacting molecule and undergoes the reaction. So this is the about the concentration of the reactant. Suppose take the example of the burning wood. When wood is burn in presence of oxygen, the rate of burning of wood will be small if the concentration of oxygen is less. But when woods burn rapidly in pure oxygen as compared to the air, means when this oxygen is per se, concentration of oxygen is more, then the rate of reaction is high, and suppose it is low, then rate of reaction is very low. Means for low condition, is concentration is low and high, the again rate is low. And suppose concentration of this reacting oxygen molecule oxygen is high, then again rate is high. So this clearly shows that if the concentration of the reactants is more, the rate of reaction is also more. Then second is, what is the effect of temperature? How the temperature affect the rate of reaction? Now it is well known that if the increase in temperature increases the means the tem when temperature again the when temperature increases, the rate of reaction is also increases. So again, this is temperature is also directly proportional to the rate of reaction. Means as temperature increases, rate of reaction is also increases. In most of the reaction, with every increase of 10 degree Celsius of temperature, the rate of reaction gets almost double. This is tremendous effect. An interesting observation is that such positive influence of the temperature is seen in both exothermic and endothermic reaction. Exothermic and endothermic reactions. This increase in rate reaction can be attributed to increased number of the molecular collision with increase in temperature. So this is because of the increase in the molecular collision because of the increase in temperature, and that's why the rate of reaction increases when temperature is increases. Then next is third factor, that is the nature of reactants and products. Now you know that during chemical reactions, chemical reaction is nothing but the breaking up the bonds in the reactant and formation of the new bonds in the product. Any chemical reaction involves breaking of bonds and formation of new bonds. Every bond has its own bond energy. Hence, with change in reactants and products, the bond energies goes on changing. And this is with which old bonds are broken and new bonds are formed, determine the rate of reaction. Suppose consider this example. Now this 2 moles of NO react in presence of oxygen, and it gives the sodium nitroxide, and this reaction is very fast reaction. But suppose similar type of reactant, suppose 2 moles of sodium monoxide react with oxygen, it gives the carbon dioxide, and this reaction is slow. Now see, look at this reaction. This look like a similar reaction, but one reaction is fast, another is the slow, and this is because of the nature of the reactant and product, because the bond energy of this NO molecule is different than that of the carbon monoxide, and therefore during breaking up this bond, there is a different energy is required, and for making up the new bond also different energy is required, and that's why the rate of chemical reaction totally depends on the nature of reactant, and that's why the sodium nitroxide NO is when converted into sodium dioxide. This NO when converted into NO2, this is the fast reaction, and when CO is converted into CO2, it is a slow reaction. Means this clearly shows that this rate of chemical reaction totally depends on the nature of that particular reacting molecules. Then next factor is the what is the catalytic effect or catalyst effect? Catalyst effect. So what is catalyst? Any substance or increase any substance increase the rate of particular reaction without being consumed or without taking part in a chemical reaction. Such a substance is called as a catalyst. How this catalyst affect the rate of reaction? Suppose any catalyst means such catalyst work on various phenomena like adsorption, enzyme action, etc. And this effect will be studied in detail in next chapter, that is the collision theory and phenomena of catalysis. Now suppose take the example how the catalyst affect the rate of reaction. Take the example of hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. It does not give the product in normal condition, but when any catalyst is added, then it gives the product formation. To suppose consider the any catalyst, that is the finely divided powder of platinum. Suppose this is the catalyst. When this catalyst is the reaction is takes place and rate of reaction is increases. And this catalyst does not consume in the reaction, and that's why this is called as a catalyst, and whole process is called as a catalysis. So this is the role of catalyst. Means any catalyst or any substance when added to the particular reaction, the rate of that particular reaction is increases. Then next is the next factor is the surface area. How the surface area affect the rate of reaction? Now in case of the heterogeneous reaction, one of the phase in solid suppose, and more is the surface area of the reactant, there are more chances of the interaction of the reactant molecule. Hence, with the increase in surface area of the reactant, the rate of reaction is also increases. Now the surface area of the solid can be increased by decreasing the particle size. Hence, solid in the form of powder will have higher surface area, and so it will react rapidly as compared to the single block. For example, a big piece of wood burns slowly as compared to the dust or chips of the wood or pieces of the wood. So this is the effect of the surface area. It means more is the surface area, more is the surface area of substance or reactants, reacting molecule, more is the rate of reaction. Again, it is directly proportional. More is the surface area of the reactant, more is the rate of reaction. And this can be explained that suppose consider that this is the any particle, the surface area is less when it is in the block or in the united form, but when it is converted into small particles or small pieces, then surface area is more. Means any finely divided substance have more surface area as compared to the as a whole unit, and therefore when surface area is increases, the rate of reaction is also goes on increasing. So this is about the effect of how the surface area affect on the rate of reaction. So this is the about the surface area. Then next factor is radiation. How radiation affect the rate of reaction? So we know that when the bond energy of some of the bonds are such that they are broken by radiations, it behaves like like energy. When any radiation pass on a particular reactor, that bond suppose bond energy of that particular molecule, organic molecule or any reacting molecule is less as compared to the radiation energy, then it breaks and forms the new products. Then the rate of such reaction will be influenced by the radiation. The function of radiation is to break some of the bonds. The reaction involving radiation generally involves free radicals formed by the homolytic fission. And therefore, the rate of reaction increases with the intensity of radiation in some of the particular reaction. Means when the radiation, when intensity of radiation increases, then rate of reaction is also increases. Means it, again, it is directly proportional. Suppose the intensity of radiation increases in for particular reaction, the rate of reaction of that particular reaction is also goes on increasing. So this is the another parameter which affect the chemical reaction. And lastly, we discussed about the pressure. What is the effect, how the pressure affect the rate of reaction. Now consider a container, and this is the gas molecules, different gas molecule, and suppose pressure is increased, then this is the high pressure and this is the low pressure. Now when pressure is applied, the gas molecule is compressed, and when it is compressed, therefore there is a more possibility of the interaction or more probability of interaction and undergoes the collision, and that's why the rate of reaction is increases. Means as pressure increases, the rate of reaction is also increases. So in this way, these are the various factor which affect the rate of different chemical reaction. Thank you. We will discuss the next part of this chemical kinetics. Thank you.